Parthaya. Pratibodhitam Bhagavata Narayanena Swayam Vyasena Vritam Purana Munina Madhye Mahabharatam Advaitam Mrita Varshinim Bhagavatim Ashtadashadhyayinim Ambatvam Anusandadhami
Bhagavad-gīte
Bhavad-dveshinim
Vasudeva-sutam-devam
Kamsa-charnu-ramardhanam
Devaki Paramanandam
Krishnam Bande Jagat Guru. We were studying the ninth chapter, which has been in the Bhagavad Gita, it's called Raja Yoga. The ninth chapter up to almost 30, all the verses?
29.
Up to all the verses, I think we chanted, but again we'll do it. Now, from 29, we will stop. But just before that, on 27th verse, Raja Yoga, 9th chapter, it says, is a practice, spiritual practice. What is the spiritual practice? Very simple. Whatever you do, just give it to God. Whatever. And then the God Himself is telling, Yat Karoshi, Yat Asnasi, Yat Yosi, Yadasiya, Yat Tapasati Kaunteya, Tat Kurusha, Madarpanam. Yat Karoshi, whatever you are doing. Now, the thought is also there. You're also thinking sometimes, and that I have to offer to God. And since I have to offer to God, obviously I'll be careful. The bad type of thoughts I cannot offer. It's not possible. So that restrained me. The moment I think, see, the God is giving things so simple. You need not to do much. Whatever you are doing, just offer to me. Now, a sensible person, naturally, those who are believing God and try to realize God, try to come close to God, they're sensible people. So they will think, how is it possible for me to offer these bad thoughts to God? So I should be careful about my thoughts too. The yat karoshi, whatever you are doing, yat asnasi, the karoshi, whatever you are doing, asnasi, that you are eating. The before even drinking a glass of water, oh God, then you drink. So that means constantly you are remembering God. See the how very nicely, but in a simple way, so whole life, each and everything, we are remembering God. And that is the way of life. Hinduism is not a religion, it's a way of life. So that means each and every moment of our life should be dedicated to God, should be given to God, to the remembering of God, forget about the big things like the pujas and the other performances. So he says, yad ashnasi yad yuhoshi dadasi yad, whatever you are sacrificing, and dadasi yad, that whatever you are giving away in charity. So obviously, if you just think that I am giving it to God, in America and the Europe, they always do in a nice way, Giving Tuesday. It's a Tuesday only, and people will give. And I don't know why, suddenly they have developed the Giving Tuesday. And people, they have taken it so seriously that we have to give something on Tuesday. So what we are going to gain by that, if I give it on Monday or on the Wednesday, what is the difference? But it has gone into the, that is called the business, the mind. They develop in such that way. So Giving Tuesday. In our country also, what they will do in some pujas, Navaratri, Durga Puja, and you must purchase the new clothes. With the old clothes, you should not go to the temple. So that means the economy also develops. At that particular age, year, on that particular time, the mindset of the people, I must have to purchase something new. So it goes in the society life also. The society people, I must eat something good. I must go out with my family. So the money is going to all different sections of the society, and at the same time, you are thinking that you are practicing religion. And that religion, practice of religion, will be really, really good if we can take this instruction of Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Yat karoshi, yad ashnasi, yad juhosi, dadasi yat. Whatever you are giving in charity, I am giving to God. I am not giving to anyone else. But that much. That just that thought, that purifies your mind. Yat tapasasi kaunteya tat kurusha madarpanam. This is the simplest practice that the God has given. You should fast for the whole month and then you should do this. Nothing. Each and every moment remember me. It's a beautiful way. And then he is telling in the 28th verse, Shubha Ashubha Aloi Rebam Moksha Se Karma Bandhanaihi. Shubha Ashubha Aloi Rebam, good and bad, whatever it may be. So when you are freed from the bondage of action, if I am giving everything to God, it doesn't belong to me, so I am not supposed to get the result of it. So I am in the office doing some job, and whatever the best way possible, I am doing it, and then ultimately I am offering it to God. And I am not expecting any result out of it. It is in the hand of the God. And if everywhere I am giving it to God, suppose it is a failure, I should be completely clear mind. I tried my best. Suppose it is a failure, not that every time you will be successful. Suppose it is a failure. I am not going to break down, oh, what I have done. So what is there? So sometimes in a game, particularly in our country, the soccer, and they have gone, only the goalkeeper is there, but the person is a very good player. But only is a round-shaped ball, and he kicked it. It didn't go in the right, in that goal. It went somewhere else. Everybody will criticize him. Now it needs tremendous mental power to stand those criticisms. You have to come back smiling face to your family. You have to be with everything. All people, hey, what you have done? What? I tried my best. How it is possible if you give it to God? If the credit goes to God, you know, God, I tried my best. You know. Because you reside with me. And so you are free from the tension. What we need in our life? Free from tension. How it is possible? give it to somebody else. So that was, the God is ready to receive it. Give it to somebody, God. Something to God. So the, he is telling in this way that it is the whatever that give it to the God. So good and evil. Look at it, good and evil. That means the success and failure, both you have to give. But we should try to give success. Why? I am offering to God the best thing. I cannot give God which is not useful. So that, those rotten things, and I cannot offer. I should be very, very careful that I am offering this. In the southern India, there is also the practices are there that they will pour the water on the top of the god. And that is it. Ardha Kumbha Snana, Purna Kumbha Snana, they will carry the that pitcher full of water and pouring. What is that? What we are pouring? Our karma phala. We are giving to God. When we are giving to God our karma phala, should we not be careful? Oh, that I should have done something good, and that good I am giving to God. So all through the life we should be careful. But unfortunately, we have forgotten these. And those who are in the leading, those who are asking people to do it, through these rituals, the morality should be very high. What is religion? Nothing but morality. Religion is nothing but morality. And morality should be so high that we are much, much better than the animals and others. The same type of mind. But we can control our emotions. So how it is possible? Through God. And what we are going to do? We are offering our actions to God. So we must be careful. Even after the death, when a man is going to dead bodies on the pyre, just before lighting the pyre, his son is carrying the water pitcher, the earthen pitcher particularly, and it'll go around, I think, 3 times or 7 times, whatever. And the pitcher will be, the someone will make a hole, the water is falling. All this every time we do, even at the time of the Prime Minister, President, their children are also following the same thing in the Hindu way. But what is that water? Our karma phala. And we are leaving our karma phala here itself. The symbolic. I don't like to carry the karma phala. But only water, that is only symbol. And if we are not practicing to leave our karma phala every time, regularly, whether the pitcher full of water falling or not, that will go along with us. See, if only we could understand this, at least to some extent, 50-60%, will restrain all our bad thoughts and actions. Why? Because they are going to follow me. And then I will be suffering in my next life. No one will be there to save me. I cannot blame others. So this is the main thing. So he says over here, so you have to give everything, and then with the heart steadfast in yoga of renunciation, you get the liberation. Steadfast, that is on the, then comes the 29th verse. Let us chant the 29th. And to whom we are giving, the God himself is introducing himself. He is introducing what? Samoham sarvabhuteshu.
Samoham sarvabhuteshu.
Na me deshyasti na priyaha.
Na me deshyasti na priyaha.
E bhajanti tumam bhaktya.
E bhajanti tumam bhaktya.
Mai te teshu chapyaham.
Mai te teshu chapyaham.
Now, what is this? Whom we are offering? we call God, as the people say Krishna, but who is he? His behavior, you look at it. He is asking to give all the karma phala, but what is he? Samuham sarva bhutesh. That is the beauty. He is equal to each and every being. Name deshyasti na priyaha. Desha and priya. He is not having any enmity with anyone. I dislike these people and I like these people. No, they are all similar, all equal. Of course, in the 12th chapter we will read, from the 13 to 19, he said, those who are having these qualities, I like them. That is of course there. I like them. Why? Because that is the inspiration. I like to be in the good book of the God. And I must have this type of quality so the God will like me. So the God is giving the list of all those qualities from 13 to 19 verses of the 12th chapter. That will come afterwards. Here it says, Samuham sarva bhuteshu, I am the same in all beings. To me there is none hateful or dear. I do not have any choice. And that will give, when you are giving the explanation beautifully, they will explain. Those who worship me with devotion are in me, and I too am in them. How it is? Now they are giving the explaining. You said that is equal. At the same time you are telling, those who worship me with devotion, they are with me. How it is? Then they say, it is just like, suppose there is a, in the Vishnu Bhagavat also, in 3-4 verses, the same telling the same thing. I am not going to quote that. But we can give, through an example like this, the God is not having any choice. How it is possible? At the same time he is telling, those who are worshipping me, they are with me. How it is possible? Suppose there is a fire. Some people go close to the fire. Fire is not going to them. Some people, out of their own, they go close to the fire and they will get the warmth. In the winter time, if there is a fire burning outside, so naturally it is so comfortable if you go close to the fire. Fire is not going to you. Now that is the reason the God said, those who are constantly worshipping me with the devotion, with the love, with the faith, that means they are coming to me. And those who are coming to God, what they will get? All good qualities. God is full of good qualities. So they will get the blessings of God automatically because they are going to God. But those who are not going, what will happen? They won't get the warmth of the fire. So if you go to the fire, you get the warmth. If you go away from the fire, you don't get that. You cannot blame the fire for that, can we? Hey, you are giving the warmth to that, those people I am not getting because you are not coming close to the fire. So that depends on me, my action, my thought. Mera vichar is my discrimination. That I should go to God, then surely I will get the blessings of God. So God is promising, those who worship me with devotion, e bhajanti tumam bhaktya mai te, te shu cha aham, cha aham, cha means and, I am also with them, they are also with me. How? Who are those people? Bhajanti tumam bhaktya. With a devotion, those who are worshipping me. What do we need to worship God? First is the faith. How the faith will come? Because we don't see God, we don't talk to God. So Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna said, you have to go to a someone who has realized God. Sadhu Sangha. What is this Sadhu Sangha? Those who have completely dedicated their life for God, living in the presence of God. So those are the people, to some extent, not completely like God, but to some extent they can give you the idea. So when you get that idea of God, from whom you get? From the monk, from the sadhu. If you get the company of a sadhu, the company of a monk, then he will be listening from him different stories, and slowly, slowly you will have an idea about the God, conception of God. Why sadhu sangha? To develop the conception about God. And when you develop the conception of God, though you have not seen God, talk to God, but you will have a liking for God. How it is? Like someone who lives in America goes back and talks to their friends. America has so many facilities, and there are so many good universities, opportunities. So if you appear in the exam, if you can go to the America, if you can enroll yourself in a college and you get a certificate, you get so many wonderful opportunities over there. So how he could develop the love for the person, love for the place over here? From that friend. Who is that friend? Who lives in America. So you have to go to a monk, a sannyasi, a sadhu, that satsang as they call in Hindi. The sat means the very wonderful person who lives in God. Then he will talk about the God. He will tell you about the God. Slowly he will develop the faith. That is the benefit of the sadhu sangha. The sadhu, the person who is a monk, he cannot give you all the help to realize God. That you have to develop. Only he, what he can do, he can help you to give an idea about God. Then he will suggest, you better read these books. And you open the books and then you hear, you read, oh good. Then you are slowly you are developing the interest. And your intellect is getting clear. And now you understand what is God. So that is the idea. God doesn't mean that something miraculous. Of course miracles are there, but at the same time God is nothing but the good quality. And what happens if you are having those good qualities? Your mind becomes broad. Thinking becomes varied. The clarity of thought is of course there. No ambiguity about all those things. What will happen, what will not. No ambiguity. Your clarity of thought. And slowly you can develop those qualities which has been listed in the holy books. And when you slowly develop those wonderful qualities, you yourself can understand. And tomorrow, day after tomorrow, the Sunday, in our talk, we will read, as the Uddhava, he is going to his friend and guide, Sri Krishna, who has decided to give up the body. And this Uddhava is crying that if you go, who will guide me? The Krishna is telling, your own self will be your guide. Your mind will be your guide, as Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna said. The purified mind is your guide. What is a purified mind? Clear thought. And what is a clear thought? If I am not thinking negative, if I am not performing in any negative way, as best as possible, I am not going to do any harm to anyone through my action, through my thought, through my words. I am not going to get anything wrong, that's for sure. And the more you are developing that, the love will come in your mind. And that love, that will, you feel love for each and everyone, even if you don't know those people. That is the sign of God realization. Those are the signs of God realization, not the marks, not all the quoting from the holy books, no. So this is the practice of religion. That's why Swami Vivekananda said, tons of words. People can go on talking about the God. Anyone, if you go, the Christian, there are hours they can give a talk. The Muslim, the Hindus, the Buddhists, and anyone. And they can go on talking, but the tons of words, talks only. But Swamiji said, an ounce of work is much better than the tons of talks. So that we have to remember. That's why Bhagavan said, Samoham Sarva Bhuteshu, don't blame me. I am not going to give something extra to those people because I prefer. But they come to me. Sometimes some people, they always complain. You know, in India, a lot of population. So it's very difficult for the Swamis to talk. Here, we wait for the people to come. If by chance they come, then if they like or not, we'll go on talking with them. But in India, so many people, regularly in Belur Math, if you go, thousands, from morning to evening, nearly 20,000 people will be visiting. How the monks can talk to them? And then we have the hospitals. And in the pressure of the hospital, here you go to any hospital, no crowd at all. Where are the doctors? Where are the patients? Only thing, you have to go inside, then only you'll find some activity. And in Indian hospitals, you need not to go inside. From 1 mile away, you can see. So many people, one person is sick, then 20 people following him and pressurizing on the doctor. If you cannot make him all right, we are going to beat him. So all these things are happening. So naturally, police is also there. So there's a crowd. How can you expect that they will quietly talk with you? Because it is not possible. So sometimes some people who are very close to us, they come, they see, they talk to us, then slowly, slowly it becomes, the Swamis become acquainted with them, they know them. So if they come, I come, then they will sit, they'll offer a cup of tea, they'll have some chat. Other people will criticize. Look at that. They have the favoritism. They only talk with chosen people. They won't talk to us. You never came to us. We were not introduced. How can I talk to you? We have to understand the situation. So this is the, sometimes some people from India, they visit, and when they come to us, and I love to talk. So naturally, when they come, I stop all other work and say, where from you are coming, what is the... Oh, yeah, I go and talk. Afterwards, they always say, you are so good, Swami, you talk to us, but when you go to Velur Math, nobody looks at us. I tell, because they are so busy. When I was in Velur Math, I used to do the same thing, because there's no chance, no time. We have to understand the situation. Here the people, those who are going to God, obviously developing the good qualities and happy, other people who never go to God will criticize. Look at this. God is only favoring those who are offering food to God. That is not true. If you go to God, then only you will get the blessings of God. So he said like this, and afterwards in the third verse 30, he is telling, and the great assurance. Here it says, Api chetsu duracharo,
Api chetsu duracharo,
bhajate mam ananya bhag,
bhajate mam ananya bhag,
sadhureva samantavya,
sadhureva samantavya,
samyak bhavasito hi saha,
samyak bhavasito hi saha.
Now here it says, api chet suduracharo, sudurachar, durachar, those who are doing bad work, su mean the extreme type of people. Very, very bad people. But even then, if they come to God, they also become enlightened. Because the God is the light. Whoever will go will be enlightened by God. This is the wonderful thing. There is no permanent condemnation. You have committed sin, you will go for the permanent condemnation, permanent hell. No, not like that. This is the assurance of the Hinduism. And they always say, the human being means his thoughts. We do action, our good work and bad work, but the behind all the good and bad, thoughts are there. So if we control the bad thoughts means those thoughts which are going to harm others. Those are the bad thoughts. Suppose you think that I am going to eat this, I will cook myself and I will eat this, nothing wrong. You are not going to harm others. So that is the way we have to understand. Anything that I am thinking which will harm others, and I am doing which may harm others, and that's why you know those who are writing books, or the politicians and the social leaders, and also those who are developing the movies, because the effect of those movies are tremendous on the minds of the people. And if you go on giving the negative things, and which are observed by the young people, those who are not having the discrimination, and there are villagers, those who are grown up, but they don't have that type of discriminations. And the movies, obviously, is very strong, the method of teaching. If you go on giving the negative thoughts, and people are going and purchasing tickets, you are earning a lot and you are a good successful businessman, but you know what you are doing? You are actually committing sin, a great sin. None of you will be spared, none of you, because they are thinking, oh, I am not doing anything wrong. I gave the suggestions, people are supposed to accept it or not, but no. So that is why sometimes nowadays it has become so easy. Just like and dislike or forward. The one finger, just you praise, and it goes to reaches to 1,000 people. And very wrong idea, misconception, gossip, and harming people by that way. Just your one finger took you to one step to hell. We don't know. We don't understand. And oh, that came to me, so I forwarded. Now you cannot do that. But why? Because God has given you a hate. And there is a thought. Why don't you understand? Whether this information that has come to me, a good or bad, I have to understand that. Then only I should do. Why should I involve myself into that? So that we have to be very, very careful. But if you are thinking everything positive, good positive thinking, forward it to others. Why? That will help you. Not only you, but many others. What is that? The someone helping a person. Sometimes the very good information that comes. One little boy, he was hungry, he was without clothes, and he was all the time begging to the people so that he can clean the shoe, and with that he can earn little money. Then a gentleman said, why you are doing this? I like to earn money. What about your parents? They can't help me. So the gentleman took him, gave him education, and taught him how to develop, and slowly, slowly that person, that young boy, had grown up into a very good businessman. And he never forgot that. He also, the 50% of his income, he started helping others. That's a good message. That's a good message. You should share. So that we know what is good and what is bad. So we should be careful. that I should not be a part of a false gossip which may create tremendous reaction in the human society. So we think that when you are going to the temple, that much is the religion. No. Each and every action, every thought is counted. So God is telling, Opi chetsu duracharo bhajate mam ananyavad. Now, if I committed sin in previously, sudurachar, now I came to know about the good way, I said, okay, from now onwards, I am going to do good. The God will be gracious on you. And there are examples. In the life of Bhagavan Buddha, there is a terrible person. His name was Angulimala. He used to kill people to rob of their properties, the things, wealth, and to count how many people he has robbed and killed, he used to cut their fingers and made a garland of that. Anguli means the finger, and mala means the garland. The Angulimala, you can imagine the terrible person. Then Lord Buddha, one day, he was passing through that, this terrible person came, he wanted to kill. Lord Buddha was God himself. And those who have realized God, what happens to them? They can immediately control the mind of the others. Why? Because they have controlled their own mind. So immediately the Lord controlled his mind. And he said, why you are doing like this? What is the good thing that you are doing? Only for your survival, killing others? There are so many other paths. For your survival, there are so many other paths. Then the presence of the Lord Buddha, because he was God himself, a realized soul. Of course, the Buddhists now, they don't believe in the existence of God, but we consider Buddha as God himself because all those wonderful qualities, it is only a God can have. So he transformed the mind of that person. And we same way we find the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We find Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, a very notorious person. He attacked Sri Ramakrishna. And the frail body we can see in this picture. So that Sri Ramakrishna, he only touched the chest with a small finger. Immediately that man was completely changed. Manmatha Gunda, they used to say. He was known as a Bengali Gunda, means a thug. So the Manmatha was his name. And he became a yogi afterwards. So how it is possible? Change the mind. So God is telling, if you come to me, your mind will be changed, your thoughts will be changed, your actions will be changed, and you'll be a changed personality. And in what sense you are going to change? From the selfishness to unselfishness. But the change will happen to me from the selfishness to unselfishness. The selfishness is all sin. Unselfishness are holy. That's all, nothing else. So he is telling that God is nothing but the holiness. And what is the holiness? Love and unselfishness. And if I come closer to God, what will happen? I will also become like that. And he said, and he should be regarded as good, for he rightly resolved afterwards. Then this is the 30th verse. In the 31 verse, it says like this. Any class here, see? What is that about? Shipram bhavati dharmatma shashashyantim nigachyati konteya pratijanihi nami bhakta pranashyati. This is a great assurance. Shipram bhavati dharmatma. Shipram means quickly. Those who are sincerely striving, quick transformation will come. Very quick transformation. We have seen people those who are coming to God in the holy life, so immediate transformation. The one young boy was there, I knew him. He was so naughty. Every day there will be complaint from the neighborhood to his parents. Every something or other. The moment he returned home, he will be followed by 2-3 people with the complaint. So his mother told Swami, what I am going to do with this boy? Every day I had to fold hands and beg pardon to my neighbors because of this. That boy slowly, I used to visit their home, used to talk with, not with him actually, with other people. Sometimes we'd be sitting, listening. Slowly, slowly he understood that we are liking those people who are good just to get some compassion, love. So he started visiting the society, started taking part as a volunteer, started reading books. Then he joined as a brahmachari in the Ramakrishna mission. Now he's a monk, he's a very good monk. And all like him very much. All like him. So that I'm not, because he's a very young sadhu, so I also like him, that how he was transformed, shipram bhavati dharma atma, very quickly. And why he? Me also. I was thinking completely in a different way. And when I came in contact with the monk, and slowly everything changed. And so fast. Even my close friends, they were wondering, hey, what is it? You have changed a lot. So that shipram bhavati dharma atma. So this is possible. And he is telling, konteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati. Pratijanihi, know it for sure. The never destroyed, pratijanihi, know it for sure. That na pranashyati, they will never be in a bad thing, in a bad shape. Always, those who are coming to God, trying to keep with the company of God, that means all good thoughts and good actions, they will be always good. And how you will know? Confidence and joy. How I will know that I am really proceeding towards God? Suppose I have become a monastic. Suppose I have become a devotee. I regularly visiting the temple and reading good book and giving charity, helping others, all these things. And taking the name of God. How I will understand that I am truly progressing? Two things will happen. One, you will have complete self-confidence, no fear. And second, always joy within. For everything you will have the joy. Whatever. Normal life that you are living. Not that everybody should become a monk. Those who are living in the household. Naturally, they have different type of responsibilities. You were invited by your friends to visit their house. Obviously, you will also invite them. So then they will come, they will have a friend. The talking, laughing, singing, and then exchange of gifts and food. All these things to naturally go. But you will always feel a joy and self-confidence. Whatever I'm doing good. So that is the symbol that you are going towards God. You are proceeding, progressing in the realm of spirituality. And the realm of spirituality doesn't mean that you should be grave, you are not shaving beard, and you are wearing dirty dresses. No, not like that. Wrong conception. You should be very clean and very nicely, properly dressed, very courteous and gentle behavior, or many people will start loving you, liking you. They will come to talk to you. Those are all the symbols. And that is the reason once what happened. Brahma, the creator, he was a little bit confused. Because when the Supreme God, Lord Vishnu, took the Krishna form and he was playing with the cowherd boys and they went to the pastur, and the Brahma was confused. Is this the ordinary boy? Is that our God? The Supreme God has become this boy? And he is playing with the friends and like that, young people, they're making prank and all these things. Oh, this is our Supreme God. No, it cannot be. So the out of doubt what Brahma did, he took all those boys and the cows. And Brahma, he was having all power. He hid them somewhere. The young Krishna was, I think, taking a nap. So when he woke up and he found, well, nobody's there. They all know. So immediately, who understood, oh, Brahma is having doubt and he is trying to examine me. Okay. Out of this creation is God's creation. How he created, just he thought. And the same process he applied. Immediately those many cows and all those boys all came. And it was almost dusk. So the Krishna with his friends, they came back. Now a new thing happened. All the villagers, all the parents, they started loving the cows and the calves and their boys, the children, so much. Much more than their own children. Why? Because they were God. All the God manifested in them. Krishna has manifested as God and the calf and also the boys, cowherd boys. So obviously love. People will start loving you, liking you. They will love to come to you, to talk to you, to give you some gift. Why? Because of this. So these are the symbols that I am proceeding in the right path. And I will never ever do any mistake if I am always aware that I am not doing anything. It is because the God is manifesting within me. So otherwise it is nothing. So that's why Shipram Bhavati Dharma Atma Shasha Shantim Nigachati Kaunti Apratijanihi Name Bhakta Pranashyati. If you are devoted to God, God will protect you. Whatever may be the challenges in your life, there will be a lot of temptations in your life. The people, as because you are developing in spirituality, the people will come and give so much of respect, so much of gift, money. Majority of the people, they slip from there. It's the hardest thing. The last hurdle that you have to jump. Otherwise, everything was all right. Majority, they are stuck over there. That is the problem. Mam hi patha vyapa sritya. Epi su papayonayaha.
Epi su papayonayaha.
Striyo vaishya statha shudra.
Striyo vaishya statha shudra.
Depi yanti param gatim.
Depi yanti param gatim.
So naturally, they become righteous soon. And what happens to them? No, sorry. This mam hi partha. But taking the refuge in me, they also, though might be inferior birth, this is the very difficult line. In the modern world, the Krishna's time, I don't know, there was no women movement perhaps. So he said like that. But here, what is that? He said, striyo, vaishya, tatha shudra tepiyanti param gatim. So we know, the striya that everybody knows, all the women, and vaishya, it is not in the Europe and American, the caste system is not there. But in us, we are having the caste system. What is that? That those people who are doing the business, actually looking after the economy, tatha shudra, those who are the physical labor, Yanti Parangatim, the three types of people, Stri, then the Vaishya and Shudra. We will come to this, Mam hi partha vyapasritam. Just before that, he said, anyone coming to me, very quickly they become righteous. Dharmatma, what is that? Dharma, righteous. So, I have given you the word, I will surely keep it. The one person wanted to give us some donation. And how can I believe you and you don't believe? And don't give donation. And if you give the donation, believe. So, if you want to be here to see how I am spending your little money, then you don't give. And if you believe, then you give, and I promise that whatever purpose that you will give, we will spend that. What else we can do? So this is the thing, the righteousness. No, there cannot be 2-3 people 24 hours to look after me, whether I am righteous or not. I am righteous. When I was young, so naturally you can understand, the parents were always thinking what will happen to my son. The mother told me, see, we cannot go on polishing on you every time. But I want that my son, whom I love so much, should not do anything by which my head will hang in shame. Please don't do that. Believe me, in a very young age, that one word of my mother, never allowed to do anything. Never allowed to do anything. Young age, naturally, the friends used to do these, that. I couldn't do. I could never do. Only that word of mother, if the mother comes to know about it, she will not like it, perhaps. So how, that is righteousness. So I am taking the oath, the belief on myself, faith in myself, I am not going to do anything wrong. No one will take care of. Who is going to see? So we have come far away, 10,000, 2,000 miles away from the headquarters. No one around. And we are taking everything. Even the, when the water is falling from the tap, I always go and close it. Why? Because the wastage of the money. The devotees are giving the money to us. We should not waste it. Whatever is possible, even you know that we have seen, the people are going on taking the paper, the hand, what's called?
Paper towels.
Only one or two is sufficient. They will go on taking 4, 5, 6 and just like that and throw. We cannot do it. Because from the poor country we have come, we know how much it costs. And if we are saving it, it will be useful for others. So like that, nobody is telling me, should be careful, careful and careful. Why? Because I have promised to myself, I will be righteous. So I am righteous. So this he is telling that immediately, and then afterwards he said, Stri, Vaishya, Shudra. But you know why he said that? You will wonder, it's not generalized. Usually, the ladies, they are very much attached to this samsara. It's not the husbands, it's the wife that maintain the house. They are careful about the children. You will find the husband, immediately they will leave the family and go away. But the mothers will never ever desert the children. They will be with the children. Sometimes, unfortunately, we have seen the separation. And I have seen the mother crying to get the child, though she is not having any support. Still she wants to take the responsibility of the child. Why? Mother. That is mother's heart. They are so much attached to this world. That is the reason, another way, they are attached to the samsara. And you know, the women, they are very aesthetic and they love the beauty by nature. The male is not like that, mostly. But the women, they will never think, keep like these or that. Anyone visiting, women are very promptly will keep everything in decent way. They know what type of the color of the cloth will be good and these and that. Male don't, because of the nature. But the problem, because of that nature, they are more bound to the samsara. So God is mentioning that and nothing else. And here I will give you a big list of the women who were highly respected by our tradition, Hindu tradition. They are Bach, who was the creator of the Upanishad and the what's called the great Bach. She created the Ratri Shukta from where the Kali conception came. This Bach. She is a Rishi, Lady Rishi, considered. Then Opala, the Vishwavara, Agasti, and famous name, almost everyone knows, Gargi, Maitreyi, Shandili, Shoroshi. You know the Shoroshi? She was the guru of Ashtavakra. Can you imagine? The Ashtavakra, that Ashtavakra Gita Samhita, we are studying in the Hindu temple, Lemon. And Ashtavakra's guru was Shoroshi. Then Leela, Madalasa, Salva, and there are so many names. I only this many. And this Salva was the guru of Janaka. So they are not ordinary ladies. Then the businessman, the Vaishya, Samadhi, Tuladhara, we read from them, about them. The Samadhi is the person, he was not tempted with the Maya. Rather the king, he was. And when the mother appeared, the Devi Durga appeared, the Samadhi, the Vaishya told, enough with all these things. Now I want liberation. Then the Shudra, the very low-born people, Janasruti, Jabala Satyakam, then Oilokitaba, all these. Ashura, Prahlad, the great name, Bali, the Bitra, Vibhishana. So who can say that because of the low bar they won't have to realize God? They are the people. So when the God is telling, it's not condemning the whole rest. Some only. Why? Because those people physically working, they become so tired. So they are constantly thinking about the survival. They can't think of higher things. That is one thing. Vaishyas, the business community, they are so much interested to develop their business and earn the profit. Not much time for the religion. And sometimes they deceive themselves. They think, let me earn money by whatever means. And then some portion of that I will donate to the temple and I am free from the sin. Wrong. It cannot be. But anyway, so that's why the God in mentioned about these. Then it comes to 33 and the 34. With these two together we will read. Kim puna brahmana punya.
Kim puna brahmana punya.
Bhakta rajashayastatha.
Bhakta rajashayastatha.
Anityam asukham lokam.
Anityam asukham lokam.
Imam prapya
bhajasyamam. Imam prapya bhajasyamam.
Manmana bhavamad bhakto.
Manmana bhavamad bhakto.
Madhya jimam namaskuru.
Madhya jimam namaskuru.
Mame vaishyasi yuktaivam.
Mame vaishyasi yuktaivam.
Atmanam matparayanah.
Atmanam matparayanah.
Then here it says, that what need to mention the holy brahmanas. Now when this type of people can realize God, realize me, what about those brahmanas? Means those who are already controlled. You know, Swami Vivekananda, he never talked about the duality of God. He spread it Advaita over here in America and Europe. Right? You know why? Because of the social conception. They always think about the good of everyone. And at least, I don't know whether truly or not, in the social behavior, they're so courteous. Whenever you're meeting the eye of someone else, unknown, at least he or she will smile and greet. Whenever we rude and they are not curious to know about your personal thing, they're so courteous, majority of the people, not at everyone. And it is not. So these are the good qualities, that means they are having the control of their senses. So Swamiji spread it Vedanta. What is that Vedanta? I am divine. And I respect a person, not because as a person, but because the divinity, that much. If these people can understand this, you can imagine 80% they have already reached. And because of our society, because of the history and the the geography and the economy, sociology, if we go back 1,000 years almost, we are ruled by a peculiar type of people, and we lost our originality, slowly coming back. So naturally, obviously, it will take long time for us to come back to the original way. We cannot blame the Indians. They are good people, but little bit confused. And that confusion because of this. 1,000 years, and we cannot expect that with 60, 70 years, everything should be corrected. No. Obviously, it is coming back. But these people, they are already having this. Now, if only they can understand, so he said like that. Think about those people who are so much attached to these worldly things. For them also, there are chances to get God realization. And those who are Brahmanas, already self-controlled. It will be so easy. Now, he last, in 34th verse, he said, Manmana bhava madbhakta. Madhyaji mam namaskuru mame vaishyasi yuktevam atmanam matparayanah. He said, me. Who is this me? Some people they say Krishna. Of course Krishna. But who is this Krishna? Not only this form. Yet the Krishna means, you can show the Krishna's picture if it's possible. It's not only this Krishna that is talking about. It's not professional, that's why. You have to tell. So obviously, so this is not the Krishna, of course the God, the manifestation of God, but not only this form. It says the Brahman, the Paramatman. Who is this me? Paramatma. Manmana bhava madbhakta, dedicate yourself and become associated with me. What is that? Me, the God, the Supreme, the Brahman. Madhyaji, worship me. Mam namaskuru, be humble with me. Mame vaishyasi yuktaivam atmanam, and be attached with me. How it is possible? Go on taking the holy name of God. That is the easiest way. And that the Lord ultimately, he says, that be steadfast. How it is possible? Take the name of God constantly. So that's why the diksha, that is a wonderful, all the diksha in it is everywhere. In the Christianity and the Islam and the Buddhism, they go on taking the name of God. Hinduism, of course, it is there. But taking the name of God, actually living in the company of God. That is the, okay, thank you. Let us conclude this particular chapter with this. I don't know whether your books are having this or not. We conclude in this way. Iti Sri Mahabharate.
Iti Sri Mahabharate.
Shatasahasram.
Shatasahasram.
Samhitayam.
Samhitayam.
Vaiyasikyam.
Vaiyasikyam.
Bhishma Parmani,
Bhishma Parmani,
Srimad Bhagavad Gitasu,
Srimad Bhagavad Gitasu,
Upanishatsu,
Upanishatsu,
Brahma Vidyayam,
Brahma Vidyayam,
Yoga Shastre,
Yoga Shastre,
Sri Krishna Arjuna Samvade.
Sri Krishna Arjuna Samvade.
Raja Vidya Raja Guhya Yoga Nama.
Raja Vidya Raja Guhya Yoga Nama.
Namo Madhyaya.
Namo Madhyaya.
We are concluding the 9th chapter. So after this, and then I think she will announce. So January and February, this is a very difficult 2 months here in Chicago. Too much of the snow and the cold. And most of our devotees, they go out of the city. So once again, we will meet in March. So please announce that. And thank you. Stay warm. And please repeat after me 3 times, Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti.
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 Hari
Om. Hari
Om. Tat Sat. May you all be happy and healthy. That is my prayer. And after 2 months, once again, we will meet you. Maybe in this day and time.